A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 31st August, on the front page you have 10 public sector banks to be merged. So this is the second wave of government's efforts to revive the economy. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman announced a slew of banking reforms measures, which includes merger of 10 public sector banks into 4 entities. So this, it says, would take the number of banks in the country from 27 to 12. So here you can see, these will be the banks which will be merged together, like PNB, Oriental Bank and United Bank would be merged. So here you can see this will become the second largest public sector bank, and these are the four groups. Then this is GDP growth down to 6-year low in quarter one. So manufacturing sector has taken a hit, and you can see that India's GDP is at a 6-year low in first quarter of this financial year. Then below you have West Bengal passes bill to prevent punish mob lynching. So it's high time center and other states follow suit, is what the West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee says. So we had seen earlier how Rajasthan has passed such a bill, and now it is West Bengal which has passed West Bengal Prevention of Lynching Bill 2019. So this has been passed by the state legislative assembly. Then this is canal completed in 42 years, washed away in 24 hours. So this is a canal which took 42 years to build in Jharkhand. It's a Jharkhand irrigation project. And then within 24 hours of its inauguration, the canal meant to provide water to 85 villages was washed away. The administration has blamed rats, rodents for it. They found rat holes which have caused damage to the canal. On page 6 you have high TB prevalence continues to haunt MP tribe. So this is a tribe from Madhya Pradesh. They are called Saharyas. So this tribe has high TB incidence. You can see it is having a TB. It was having a TB incidence of 3,003 people per 1 lakh people every year. So over a year. So this has now been brought down to 1,995 per 1 lakh people. And the national average of TB prevalence is 204 per 1 lakh people. So, and what is the reason for TB here? Tuberculosis is malnutrition, poor housing, alcoholism, and even seasonal migration. So these continue to be the risk factors. World Health Organization has set a 2035 deadline to eliminate TB epidemic. And India, which accounts for 1/4 of cases, plans to do so much ahead in 2025 itself. So if you want to eliminate TB by 2025, then the Saharyas tribe from Madhya Pradesh has to be given special focus. They said, while only 23% of Saharyas, mostly agricultural laborers, are literate, every fifth person in the community suffers from an infection. And every second child under 5 is underweight. So they also have high total fertility rate, the highest total fertility rate in the country of 4, as against a normal of around 2. So 4 children per woman. On page 9 you have collegium names judges for Supreme Court vacancies. So these are the names of judges for 4 vacancies in the Supreme Court, which have been given by the Supreme Court Collegium. Also, suggestions for appointment of chief justices in 8 high courts have been forwarded. So the government will have to make a call on it. So it can accept the recommendations of the Supreme Court Collegium, and the appointments will be made. And if it sends back for reconsideration, then Collegium can reconsider them. And if the collegium may again send back the same names, then the government has no other option but to make the appointments, or the other tool which they use is delay the appointments, just sit on the files. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Big Bank Theory. So this is regarding the front page news regarding merger of banks, so public sector banks. So this editorial says that for the mergers to work, realizing staff cost synergies is the key. So then staff of all the banks also should be merged, and how that works is important. And this is with or without. So this is regarding Brexit. Boris Johnson, the British Prime Minister, seems bent on delivering a no deal Brexit. So that's will be a huge disruptor. This is there. The lead article spelling out the government's RBI windfall. So this is regarding the huge surplus which the RBI passed on to the central government. So it says the final impact of such infusions on the bank's independence would depend upon the future course of such transfers. So whether this is a one-time thing or whether such transfers, huge surpluses, would be paid, you know, regularly every year. Then what is the how the bank, the RBI, would stay independent is the question being raised here. And this is liberalism runs into national populism. So this talks of how no country has found the golden mean between free range liberalism and statism. So we have to be liberal and we have to support the state as such too. So how the two work together, how to maintain a balance between the two, like giving up people liberty as well as controlling protests. So that's there. Then on the op-ed page on Saturdays, you have Ground Zero coverage. So this is regarding central government's decision to convert Ladakh into union territory. So this set of celebrations in Leh, but there are concerns raised in Kargil. So what are the expectations and apprehensions of the people here is mentioned, you can see. On page 12, you have expect peace after NRC release, says Assam DGP. So he says that situation is normal and under control. And after the NRC, final NRC is published today, you can see that he's sure that there will be peace maintained. So this entire timeline of the NRC exercise given here, like how first NRC of Assam was published in 1951. Post-independence, and then you can see all Assam students unions demanded the update of this NRC in 1980s, and finally Assam Accord was signed with NRC update as point of agreement. Then in 2009, again an NGO moved Supreme Court claiming that 41 lakh foreigners are in state's electoral votes. So then central decides to conduct pilot NRC project in 2010, and this pilot project succeeded, but death of 4 in police firing halted the exercise. And then in 2017, first draft NRC was published, and since then we are seeing drafts being published, claims and objections finalized, and finally the draft final NRC is going to be published on 31st August 2019 today. Then on page 13, you have J&K children to get psychological first aid. So hospital opens child friendly centers as the long lockdown can inflict psychosocial trauma on children in Jammu and Kashmir. So this is Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences of Government Medical College in Srinagar, which has opened this these child friendly centers for psychological first aid. And then here you have India Pakistan to join SAARC event in US. So India and Pakistan are expected to participate in the foreign minister level meeting of SAARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation, in New York on September 26. Then on international page, again, we have the same news on Hong Kong crackdown on protesters, Amazon firefighting. But what's important here is regarding Brexit strategy. So this is actually an explainer that what's Boris Johnson's Brexit strategy. So this is also an editorial today. So the British Prime Minister Boris Johnson has narrowed the lawmakers' opportunities to reject his Brexit plans. So he wants a no-deal Brexit, and what does he actually intend to achieve is detailed out here. Then on business page, you have Punjab National Bank gets lion's share of recapitalization. So the recapitalization initiative in which government provides money to the banks, actually. So it is done after reviewing banks' fundamentals. So recapitalization of 70,000 crore plus has been provided. So this is the bifurcation amongst the banks, public sector banks. Punjab National Bank gets a lion's share of this recapitalization. And then here you have, can 10 weak banks together create 4 large strong banks? So this is a question raised. It says 9 of the 10 banks have net non-performing assets of over 5%. And they are close to the prompt corrective action risk threshold. So they have all been merged, the front page news. Punjab National Bank is also one of the banks amongst these 10. So this is the issue covered here. And below you have appellate tribunal dismisses government plea in video con case. So National Company Law Appellate Tribunal has dismissed government's plea. So this is regarding the demand of center of $314 million towards its share of profit petroleum. So you know this Rawa oil field of Videocon, in this central government sought its share, which has been the demand has been dismissed by National Company Law Appellate Tribunal. Then on the last page, there's sports news. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. You can download the PDFs from there. Thank you.